Welcome. Please insert key card. Processing. Access to Site81's database has been granted. Secure. Contain. Protect. Warning. The following file is level 44847 classified. Any attempt to access this file without level 44847 authorization will be logged and will lead to immediate disciplinary action. Item hash, SCP-4847 object class, Keter Lightlidamon2.jpg area prior to Foundation presence special containment procedures, currently, SCP-4847 is uncontained. The Foundation has installed a subterranean containment facility under an uninhabited island in the North Atlantic Ocean, designated Area Comma, in preparation of SCP-4847's containment. Area has been constructed around a central gigafauna containment cell, fitted with 12 Scranton reality anchors and 8 Dachin disruptor engines. The single blast door leading to the containment cell is to be permanently sealed upon SCP-4847's containment. In the event of containment breach, all on-site personnel are to immediately initiate Procedure 39 Mobile of and notify O5 command of the breach. MTF units Lambda 5, White Rabbits, and Iota 3, Tomorrow Never Comes, are to be immediately dispatched to area. Description. SCP-4847 is understood to be a reality-altering entity of unknown origin. SCP-4847 is reported to be able to manipulate its physical form using its abilities. As such, SCP-4847 has no definitive physical description. However, it has been reported to consistently mask its form under cloud cover or light refraction. SCP-4847 is reported to have breached containment on November 22, 2018 after causing extensive damage to Site-391, where it was being contained. Given the circumstances surrounding SCP-4847's discovery, much of the information regarding SCP-4847 has been recorded from memory by members of Division Requiem. As such, certain elements of SCP-4847 may be inaccurate. Site-39 was initially discovered during MTF investigation of distress signals from an unknown location on a secured Foundation network. Upon arrival at Signal Origin, MTF units located a partially destroyed facility. Further investigation revealed numerous Foundation-style components, including one large containment cell containing multiple Scranton reality anchors exhibiting various amounts of damage. Notably, this was the only containment cell located at the facility. During the Site-39 investigation, MTF units discovered a contingent of 22 researchers in the ruins of the facility. Given that, at the time, Site-39 was not a registered Foundation installation, all researchers encountered were temporarily designated SCP-4847-1-22 and detained at site for interrogation. All of the researchers were carrying identification labeling them as Foundation personnel, although only 6 were recorded in Foundation databases as employed researchers. However, these 6 researchers were confirmed as working at other sites at the time. They were quickly brought into aid with questioning. Genetic testing of 6 pre-existing researchers and their Site-39 counterparts revealed identical genome sequences between each pair, indicating that they are, in essence, the same person, although, all 6 of the Site-39 counterparts showed marked signs of aging compared to their pre-existing versions. Analysis of 3 partially fragmented information drives recovered from Site-39 revealed documents ranging in date from 2040/to 2044/. When questioned about the date, all 22 researchers believe themselves to be in the year 2044. These answers, combined with the information drives, researcher identification, and genetic sequencing, has led the Foundation to believe that SCP-4847, Site-39, and the 22 researchers are all from a prospective point in time. This has led to the hypothesis that SCP-4847 has an understanding of, and the ability to manipulate the temporal continuum. In an attempt to nullify further temporal relocation, The 22 researchers, now known as Division Requiem, have worked with the foundation to develop technology for this cause. Document 4847. Dr. TDO, the Touch and Disruptor Engine, TDE, is an experimental collaborative effort between Division Requiem and Foundation staff intended to limit localized temporal instability. Based on current models of special relativity, the TDE is theorized to lock pockets of space-time by prohibiting superluminal molecular speeds in the surrounding vicinity. Particles in the TDE field of effect should be unable to be energized to the point of superluminal velocity, thus preventing manipulation of the temporal continuum. Due to the nature of reality-altering anomalies, conjunctive use of the TDE with Scranton reality anchors is necessary. Testing of the TDEs on other temporal anomalies is currently pending. Although the veracity of statements made by the Division Requiem cannot be proven, it currently serves as the most explicable reason for Site-39's sudden appearance. Furthermore, whilst Division Requiem is permitted to collaborate with current Foundation researchers on matters relating to SCP-4847, under constant supervision, the Foundation is still considering the possibility that Division Requiem is a fraudulent contingent with motives detrimental to the Foundation. Since the limit and scope of SCP-4847's abilities is unknown, O5 Command is treating SCP-4847 as at least a Class 3 reality-altering anomaly, and hypothetically capable of inducing a CK-class reality restructuring or CK-class reality failure event. Addendum 4847-1, Interview Log of Dr. Pride, formerly SCP-4847-16, Interviewee, Dr. Amelia Pride, formerly known as and referred to as SCP-4847-16, Interviewer, Level 5 Researcher Drive Connor Baker Spectators, Level 5 Researcher Drive Martin Vasleev, Level 5 Researcher Drive Morgan Robbins Forward, Dr. Pride is questioned about SCP-4847. Begin Log. 3:47 p.m. 2018/ Greater than Dr. Pride and SCP-4847-16 are sitting opposite each other in an interview room. Dr. Baker, please state your name. SCP-4847-16, my name is Dr. Amelia Pride. Dr. Baker, Dr. Pride, can you please tell me about SCP-4847? SCP-4847-16, I'll tell you what I know, which, admittedly, isn't much. Most of our tests didn't end well. Dr. Baker, any information is critical, as I'm sure you are aware. SCP-4847-16, yes. Well, where do I start? Keter. Reality Bender. Time Bender 2, apparently. Go figure. Dr. Baker. That brings up a question. Did Site-39 have any technology intended to prevent SCP-4847 from traveling through time? SCP-4847-16, no. We had no idea it was capable of that. Until the breach, our SRAs kept it fully in check, we had no breaches prior to the current one. It must have figured out a way around the SRAs. Dr. Baker, I'll make a note of that. Can you describe SCP-4847's behavior? Is it hostile? SCP-4847-16/pause, yes, I suppose so. But I wouldn't say it's malicious. Dr. Baker, what do you mean? SCP-4847-16, it didn't seem inherently violent, but, more self-preservative. It would attack anything we sent at it, but it wouldn't go looking for people to kill. It's almost animalistic. Dr. Baker, I see. Do you think it would be possible to reason with SCP-4847? SCP-4847-16, no, no. We tried speaking to it, but it never responded. It's obviously sentient, but it never indicated it was sapient. Dr. Baker, what else can you tell me about 4847? SCP-4847-16. Oh. Its Hume levels were always in a constant state of flux. Like it couldn't control it. I haven't seen anything like it. I saw its external Humes hit 32 once. Dr. Baker, sorry, did you say 32? SCP-4847-16, yeah. Crazy, isn't it? End log, 3:50 PM 2018/Greater than following the interview of Dr. Pride, containment priority of SCP-4847 was increased to high. Addendum 4847-2, containment attempt log 1 containment attempt log 1 MTF units, Lambda 5 Ghostbusters, Iota 3 tomorrow never comes forward, a Ukrainian helicopter pilot reported a sighting of some huge creature moving around inside a solitary thundercloud on an otherwise clear day. MTF units Lambda 5 and Iota 3 are dispatched to the reported location. Original footage is recorded on Lambda 5 Lieutenant Bulbit's helmet camera. Begin log, 11:47 AM 2019/Greater than Lambda 5 and Iota 3 are approaching the reported location of SCP-4847. A solitary thundercloud can be seen in the distance. Commander Vaughn, Bulbit, tell me again that our equipment is ready to go. Lieutenant Bulbit, check, Commander. All SRAs and TDEs operational and functioning correctly. Commander Vaughn, they better be. If I get sent back to the 70s, I'm coming for you. I hate Elton John. Lieutenant Bulbit laughs weakly. Commander Vaughn, liven up Bulbit. This'll be over before you know it. Iota 3, how are you guys doing? Commander Michaels, we're prepped and good to go. Where are we going for drinks after this? Commander Vaughn, we'll think of that when we get there. Claps hands, alright gentlemen, it's game time. Let's split, Michaels, you bank right. Commander Michaels, copy. As Lambda 5 begins banking left, all TDEs aboard Lambda 5's vehicle begin humming loudly. Lieutenant Bulbit, Commander, I'm picking up Dachshunds around Arvel. It's trying to send us back. Commander Vaughn, dispatch. Give me the time and date. Foundation dispatch, Lambda 5, the time is 11:50 AM EST, 2019/. Commander Vaughn, laughs, the TDEs are working boys. Let's get this over with. As Lambda 5 and Iota 3 begin closing, a loud roar is recorded on the helmet camera. A single, massive tendril extends from SCP-4847 and slashes at the Iota 3 vehicle. Iota 3 tries to evade, but the tendril connects with an engine and Iota 3 begins spiraling downwards. Commander Vaughn, shit. Sawyer, fire at that thing. We don't have the equipment to contain it by ourselves. Lambda 5 fires multiple missiles and artillery rounds at SCP-4847. The space around SCP-4847 begins shimmering before SCP-4847 vanishes, along with three missiles. The rest continue on their trajectory. Commander Vaughn, Michaels, do you copy? Dispatch, we've lost visual on 4847 and Iota 3 is down. The helmet cam looks at the window and sees the Iota 3 vehicle flaming on the ground below. Commander Vaughn, Sawyer, take us down. Iota 3, do you copy? Corporal Prince, this is Prince from Iota 3. I copy. Commander Vaughn, thank fuck. What's the situation down there? Put Michaels on the radio. Corporal Prince, negative Commander. Vaughn and the others, they're gone. Commander Vaughn, pause, they're all dead? Corporal Prince, no Commander, they're completely gone. I'm the only body left down here. Commander Vaughn is silent, before throwing his radio across the cabin. Lieutenant Bulbit, dispatch, confirm copy. SCP-4847 has escaped. End log, 11:53 AM 2019/. Following the failed containment and subsequent disappearance of SCP-4847, senior researcher Marvin discovered an audio log of a distress call tagged with 4847 on the Foundation database. The log was dated 1986/. The transcript is as follows, unknown, Vaughn, Do you copy? I repeat, Commander Vaughn, do you copy? Dispatch, do you copy? We're on foot. Our Liz missing and Smith and Ram are dead. We've lost sight of 4,847 and, multiple voices are heard yelling, fuck. Open fire. Open administrator note, yes, we are aware that the previous distress call indicates that SCP-4847 may no longer be present in our timeline. However, if SCP-4847 is sapient enough to communicate with other versions of itself, and they all congregate into our point on the timeline. Well, the implication is there. The Foundation will continue to prepare for SCP-4847's containment regardless of whether or not it currently exists in our point in time. 05 Footnotes 1. At the time of containment breach, Site-39 was not recognized as a Foundation installation.